everyone. In this video, I will show you how to use this device. It's a modified or it's an improved version of the previous one that we saw in the video, how to make it yourself, which was the prototype. The main difference is instead of having a wire coming out from here and then pressing it here as a switch to charge the capacitor, we have included now the switch here. So it's everything is there. There's nothing, no wires running outside. So how to use it? First of all, you press, of course, you need to have inside the batteries. Okay, it's two AA batteries, which you have to buy locally. They are not shipped together with a racket. It's forbidden from the transportation regulations. So you press with one of your fingers the main switch, the switch that's coming anyway with the racket. Okay, so you press with one of your fingers. And you see the light is on, you see, on. And then just for very short time, very short press, you press, that's it. Only for a small second. And this was enough to charge this capacitor. You can press it for longer, okay? But in this case, now it's a lot of energy that is stored in the capacitor. This specific capacitor, it's at 33 nanofarads. So it can take a lot of energy. The capacitance is quite high, and the more we keep it both switches charging, then the more it charges the capacitor, which is fine. But when we're gonna discharge it, you know, when we're gonna touch both hands here, now it's touching only one because I don't have the camera to, you know, to hold it. But you have seen the video, Mr. E, how he's using it. When gonna be the discharge through our wrists, it will be very strong. it can be painful for some, okay? I don't like to have it too strong. Already with a short charge, it's already enough to disengage, you know, the proteins that they are coming from the people around us, you know, for whom I am talking about. So you press this main switch, and then just for a moment you press to charge the external capacitor, and then you disengage. You touch at the same time, you don't press anything else, you just touch at the same time on both hands on the electrodes. It is better if you will have, you know, if you have here a copper strap, let's say, as well, and you have attached on your wrist, it will make a better contact. And what's happening, as soon as you touch at the same time both of them, the capacitor will discharge, and poof, it will go through your muscles. The muscle will contract, and they will push away your hands. You will feel it on your, you know, the muscles on your arms, the muscles on your back, the muscles on your chest. Now, in case that you will not use it, like right now, I have not used it, but here there is a lot of capacitor, still energy stored. I will show you how I know, how you can verify it as well. But in case that you will not use it immediately, it's not good to keep it stored, because, you know, by accidents, if you touch at the same time both of this one, of these electrodes, they will discharge, they will short circuit and will discharge and will shock you. Or if an animal will pass, whatever. If you're not using it, after you do the discharge, after you charge it, if you're not gonna do the discharge through your body, disengage, discharge the capacitor. How you do it this one? You just press this switch for a few seconds, okay, and then it's closing the circuit inside and discharging the capacitor. How we can know that it has been discharged or it is charged? It's very simple. You take another piece of metal or a wire. For example, here I have one cable which I have attached crocodiles. It's one piece of it's one. And then you touch here, and you see now nothing's happening. There's no difference in the voltage. I will demonstrate what will happen when it's charged. So again, I press the main switch here, the light is on, and then I press now for maybe half a second to this one, so it's still enough, it's strong, and you will see. You saw it? I charge. Okay, you heard it. Probably you did not show it. Now it did not. The camera is not appearing for whatever reason. But in the if I'm looking outside the camera, it's obvious. Check. So now we know that it's discharged. But if I charge, okay, I charge it. And now instead of short circuit with this crocodile clip, I will press this switch for a few seconds. You heard a chuck, which is activate the circuit as discharging. And now, see, I touch it, nothing is happening because it has been discharged. While if I will not short circuit with the switch for a few seconds, I charge. Poof. While if I will charge and then simply I will press this one without pressing the other one, the main switch, so I just short circuiting through this. Now even if I touch, nothing's happening. So to recap, how to use it. You press with one of your fingers that you are holding the racket, you press the main switch, the light is on, and then just for a very short period, while you are pressing, while you are holding, pressing this switch, very short, you press the second switch. Now there is enough charge here to do the job when you want, you know, to disengage the proteins that they have transmitting from the others, that they have got, you know what, all the spikes, you know what I mean. In order to discharge, it's not good practice to keep it charged. It's better to discharge it. So you discharge it by pressing this one for a few seconds, this switch for a few seconds. Now it's discharged, there is no problem, and you can verify it with another piece of wire. Always hold the plastic, not the metal itself. And you see now with that, there is no chaff, there is no spark, nothing. A good tip to know, never, when you are dealing with electricity and electrical wires or electrical surfaces, or you are not sure if there is electricity or not, never touch something with the inner part of your hands. Okay? Never touch like that. Because if there is electricity and you are grounded, you close the circuit, of course, meaning that it will pass electricity from you, because if just on the air or isolate, nothing will happen. But if, for example, I was barefoot and there was a live wire, or there was a charge from the capacitor here, and I touch like that, the muscles, the electricity, the voltage, you know, make the muscles contract. You know that, it's contracting. So if I have it, if I touch from the inner part of my finger or the palm, boop, it will close, it will contract, and then it will keep it touching all the time. Or if I do like this, and it was charged the capacitor, then my hand will close, because the electricity is contract, that make the muscles contract, so they tend to close, and that's it. And I cannot release it. Always, if you want to try something, electricity I mean, always have a habit to touch from the outside part of your hand or the outside part of your finger. Because if, for example, there was electricity and it was closing circuit through your body and your feet, etc., then automatically the muscle will contract and will move away from this point. But if I was touching like that, it will contract and it will keep me here. The same, you know, if it was a wire, never touch a wire, you know, like this, because it will close, it will grab it. Always touch the opposite way. So if there is electricity, poof, it will pull it away. Okay. This is how you are using this device. Recap, we press with one of our fingers the main switch, the light is on, and then for a very short period, a very short press, it's enough to charge. There is enough energy now here to disengage the proteins that, you know, we're gonna short circuit through our wrists. If we don't gonna use it, then we just press it for a few seconds, and then the capacitance of this capacitor here is getting empty, and that's it. And then it's safe, let's say, you know, even if we touch with both hands, like this, or with both fingers, the same hand, nothing is happening. But if it was charged, now I'm not gonna do this one, because it will grab me here. It's gonna be painful. So, I hope this was useful and informative to know how to handle, let's say, this this device safely. Okay, thank you, bye. And always remember, for maximum benefits of this device, we have to use it in, with an insulation and never touching water or be grounded, because we want the electricity to pass through the two electrodes.